Hi guys, and welcome to another Elementor video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we had a question on one of our Elementor videos. Somebody wanted an image with four icons on it. When you hover over the icons, they pop up another image. So we got four icons here. When you hover over, they're going to pop up another image. Pretty easy to do with Elementor. We're using the free version today. You can download both the free and the pro version from my affiliate link below this video. So let's get started. Let's start a new page. Give it whatever name you want. I'm going to use Elementor full width for the template down here. And I'm going to edit with the Elementor. Okay, well, first thing, let's add our first icon. And like I say, we're using the free ones here. So we've got an icon right here. And of course, you could do this with any of the modules that you see over there. Okay, there's our icon. I want to add another column because I want two and two. Add new column. Let's start styling this so we can get it the way that we want it. So I'm going to go into the actual icon itself, little blue tab right here. As you can see, it says edit icon. Choose whatever icon you want here. And there's plenty of them to choose from up there. Now you can choose the view default. I'm actually going to use stacked, and I'm going to make it square like that. Alignment, I want it to be in the center. Now let's go over to our style. I'm going to leave the primary color as it is for the moment, but I just want to make it a lot smaller. So I'm going to make the actual icon 75 pixels. Padding wise, I want it to go up as big as it's going to get, which is 100. I'm actually going to type in 120, make it even bigger. That's so we can put a nice little image behind there. Okay, when you're happy with the size of your icon and the spread, the reason I'm doing this is because for the hover effect, if we don't put a board around it, it won't disappear until they actually touch this border. If we didn't have one, it wouldn't disappear until we touch the icon. Okay, so I'm happy with the size there. Now I'm going to go into that primary color and get rid of it because I don't really want to see it. So I'm just going to click on it. I'm going to take it down to transparent. We're going to lose our little icon in the white background there, but that's okay. We'll change that in a moment. All right, let's just save that for a moment. We'll go into the section and put in the image that we want all these icons to be on the top of. So I'm going to the section, the blue tab at the top here. Going to go to style. Here's our background. If it's not like you see it there, just hit the little chevron, it'll open up. Now I'm going to hit the little paintbrush, which will give us the option of adding an image. So let's add the image that we want to add to the background of this. There it is. We can see our little icon again there, which is great. So let's go in here and do what we want this to do. I'm going to go in back into the icon module. Let's go over to style. Let's go over to advanced. And you're going to find background here. Now I don't want any background there until they hover over it. So when they not hovering, normal, nothing. When they hover over it, I want to have an image in there. So again, hit the little paintbrush icon and you can pop in whatever image you want to put in there. As you can see, we've got no image, but when I hover over it, we've got an image there. Now I want that image to cover. I don't want it to duplicate like that. So I'm going to go down to size and say cover. That's better. Okay. Let's go back in. I want that icon to disappear when we hover over it. So again, let's go back into our style, icon, normal. There's our colors for normal. When we hover over it, don't want to see it at all. So I'm going to take the opacity all the way down on this one, same as we did for the other one. So the icon actually disappears when we hover over. Okay, I want to give our column right there a little bit of margin so we've got more space in between these images. So I'm going to go into the column right there. I'm going to go to advanced and let's say give it 20 pixels all around. Just put in the 20, and if you've got this little chain highlighted like it is, it'll do all four at once. If you want to do separate values, just click on it and unhighlight it. There we go. So we've got that working. Now all I'm going to do is basically rinse and repeat to get the other icons up. I'm going to duplicate this 3 times. So go to the little blue icon again there, right click, go down to duplicate. Do the same thing again and again. So we should have 4 of them now, and you can drag them across. They're all exactly the same, so it doesn't matter which one you drag across. Now we've got 4 of them. I'm simply going to go into the next one. I'm going to select a different icon to have. Obviously you'd have images that would be appropriate to the icons that you've got. And we'll go into the background. Change up the image on hover. And the same for the next one. Back over to advanced and background, we'll change out the image there. And of course you can have these linking if you want to. By simply going to the content, and it gives you the option of linking right here, and it'll link whenever you hover over the icon there. And the image would also, because the icon's still actually there, but its opacity is 0 or transparency is all the way down, so you can't see it, but it is actually still there. For instance, the one we're in at the moment, let's just put a link in. I'll put a hashtag for a link. And you can see we've got that little hand icon now representing a link. So both the icon and the image will link to wherever you put your link in right here. Great, so let's just move on to the 4th one and we're done. And again, just choose your icon. And there's plenty to choose from here. They're using the great font Awesome, which have hundreds of icons here. And you can do a search if you're looking for a particular one. For instance, user, and put in whichever one works for you. And again, we'll go to the advanced and we'll go to images, or I should say background, and then image. And my right hand column there, I'm going to have to adjust that slightly because we did the left hand column with a bit more space. So let's do the same for the right hand column. So all we need to do is go into the column, which is the dark icon again. And we'll give it the same padding as the left, or same margin, I should say. Padding would work also, but I'm using margin. There we go. And there we've got 4 little icons. When you hover over, it's going to pop up the images. Let's publish this. And we'll take a look at what we've got. Either hit the little eye icon or the have a look right there. They're both the same. Okay, there's our image. There's our icons. When we hover over, we've got different images. And this one, of course, we've got a link. It doesn't go anywhere. It'll go to the top of the page because I just put a hashtag in to represent the link. So pretty easy to do. That's a nice little effect. So I hope that's answered your question of how to do that. Elementor is absolutely fantastic. If you're building sites for the free plugin, it's absolutely awesome. Now, I use Divi theme a lot. If I'm using the Divi theme, obviously I'm using the Divi builder, But if I use client sites, I do use Elementor all the time if they've already got their theme installed. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.